Hello everyone, how are you today? It's Kei. So this is the 6th of December on Monday. So thank you for coming back to my channel. My name is Kei and I am a Japanese full-time forex trader. And this YouTube channel is all about using Ichimoku to spot trends and reversals and to improve your trades. And the goal for this channel is to help you become a non-losing trader. So hopefully you enjoy today's video session. So since markets are ranging today, there's not much of movements. As I screen chart twice already today, I decided to talk about something that it's important to improve your tradings and also improve your trading habits. And the main topic for today is to ask the right question for yourself. So hopefully you enjoy today's video session until the end today. So let me change the screen. And just a quick disclaimer, this content is basically based on my own experience and knowledge. So when you take trades, please do add your own risk. Okay, so so I have the slide that I created before I record this video. So let me bring that up and I will talk about the importance of asking questions through this slide. Okay, so today's topic is about questioning yourself and effective way of asking right questions. And I will talk about this one step by step based on my experience. So I have been trading for the last 8 years, and for the first 2 years was losing years. Well, I mean, for the first 1 year was completely losing. And for the second year, I was almost break-even. In the third year onwards, I started to make profits. And as I look back, my own trading history from becoming losing to winning trader, I can think of a couple of breakthroughs. And one of them is asking right questions myself. So when I was losing, what I was basically doing was like this. I was checking SNS like Twitter, YouTube, and other closed community. Like Telegram, there was a Telegram in Japan also, Japanese version Telegram. I was also in that group and I was reading these posts from other people. And basically I was paying attention to this information in the world of traders and decide to take trades or decide to exit my positions through the SNS. And also I was reading blogs of traders. So I was in Japan back then, so basically I was reading the blogs of Japanese traders, but they refresh sometimes every day or every 2 or 3 hours. Sometimes they refresh reactively on the blogs. So I was subscribing to some of these blogs and reading these, what they say and how they analyze charts and markets, where they buy, where they sell, where they exit, where they put the stop loss. So my trades, I would say my trades back then was like 50%, 60%, depending on the SNS and the blog of the traders. And also I was trading by others' perspective, like I mentioned, on the SNS and the blogs. So in conclusion, basically what I was doing when I look back was simply I was not making decisions by myself. You know, I thought I did, but looking back myself back then, I was not making decisions myself because simply, I was not confident. So just practice purpose, I was, referring to these, post SNS, Twitter blogs, and I took this information as if I take trades my own, but looking back, it was not. And so, and when I realized this fact, then I realized myself that I don't really take responsibility on my trades, so I decided not to follow them. I was still referring to them, some of the blogs, I was still referring to it, but I started to decide to take trades by myself, by my own terms. And so now what I do is I analyze charts by myself and I make trade decisions by myself and I accept results by myself. So basically I do these by myself and I never read anybody else's blogs or anybody else's SNS for me to trade, for me to make trade decisions. So right now I'm taking the full responsibility on my own trades. And this was the big change actually. And I was, you know, I had to go through these losing years to be able to realize the things that I shouldn't do back then. Because I was also spending so many time on reading SNS and blogs, I was maybe spending like a couple of hours, maybe 2 hours, 3 hours reading these blogs and sometimes, you know, websites, news websites. And I decided not to. But instead, I decided to see charts myself, open up the platform myself and analyze myself with my own strategy. And when I take trades, I never looked at somebody else's signals or these informations. And when I exit, I started to do all by myself. And that actually created me confidence in myself. And especially after I started to win trades, I was feeling more comfortable in this way. And this is the reason why I don't trade for somebody else. I have been trading myself and I never traded for somebody else. And I was never into these trading firms or FTMO. I never be into these prop firms. So all my trades were actually done all myself and with my own money and with my own capital. And looking back, how I made the change from this one to here is there are multiple factors, but one of the breakthrough was when I started to ask right questions to myself and come up with right answer by myself. And when I realized this fact, then my trade improved so much. Because before, I was not really asking questions for myself. Like when I make trades, when I take trades, basically I was either taking trades kind of gut feeling, or I was using strategy. Back then I was using moving average or some other indicators, paid indicators and paid sometimes signal services I was using. But basically I was not really asking questions to myself. Basically I was thinking when I buy, hopefully the market goes upwards, or when I sell, hopefully the market goes bearish, because I made so much investment on this education and also services. So that was actually how I understood the confidence, and I took trade in that manner. So I wasn't really asking myself questions. But after I started to ask questions myself, my trades improved so much. And this is the topic for today. And this is what I would like you to do also to practice from now on after you watch this video. So the right questions are like this. So there are three categories of asking questions. So one is think of who, what, why, where, when, and how questions when you take trades. And I will give you some examples on these questions later. But this is typical like a reasoning questions when you ask somebody for the help, or when you ask somebody for to come up with the answer. These six kind of questions are said to be effective. So you can actually apply the same method, the same framework in trading when you take trades. So that's one. And after you come up, after you think of these questions, then this is a very important step. Have your own answer before asking. So So for example, like when you are in a live stream or when you write some comments or when you ask some help for somebody else, you know, you may ask, so, you know, who, what, why these questions. So for example, to me, like, why do you use Ichimoku? And what do you think about EURUSD? Or where would you place the sell? Or, you know, when would you take a trade? And how would you take trades? How would you manage stop loss? You might come up with many, many questions like this. But before asking questions to someone, or even before asking questions to yourself, you better have answer in your own. And then ask questions. So you have to have your answer first, and then ask questions. And this is very, very effective. This is, you know, reasoning your question and answer yourself and come up with this hypothesis, hypothetical answer in yourself, and then ask if it's right or wrong. If it's wrong, then you know why it's wrong, because I will give you the answer and you can compare my answer to yours and you know that it's wrong. So you can actually cover up this, you know, a gap, and you can learn from my answers. But if you cannot come up with the answer by your own and just simply ask questions to me or ask questions to somebody else, then you know, you cannot really learn from your own questions. So this is very, very effective, especially when you take trades. It becomes very effective because after all, trading is isolated process, and you know, you can't really trade together, you know, in the group. For example, like I have the Ichimoku community or GTS group, and in the group, sometimes we discuss on the markets and sometimes we take trades together. But, you know, even so, whether you take trades or not is after all based on your own decisions, and it is isolated process. So you better have to have your answer in yourself first before you ask to somebody else. So that's very important step. And I was missing this when I was reading SNS and reading blogs of the traders. And when I was trading by others' perspectives and analysis, I didn't ask myself these questions. And I didn't come up with these answers myself. So that was one of the big breakthroughs. And also ask why you come up with these answers after you come up with the answer. So this is further step down, is that the, you know, so let's say, for example, like when you look at this Euro USD, so what I say usually in the live stream or video is that the, you know, this is Ichimoku, and I use Ichimoku Kinko Hyo to capture the market trends and momentum. So as far as I see this right now, you can see that the Kumo single span B is flat, but single span A is down, and Kijun Sen is down, Tenkan Sen is flat, and the Chikou span below the candles. So this is bearish to me, so I expect the market go bearish on this reverse end wave consecutively. So that is my bigger picture analysis, and usually I say this to everyone on this community. But so you may wonder, what if single span B is flat, but is it okay? You might ask that question. And before asking that question, come up with the answer first. So like, you know about single span B. If you don't know about single span B, then you can Google search, or you can watch my previous videos on the archive to study single span B. And if you know about single span B, then kind of think about what it means by it's flat. And single span B simply means, I mean, for those who are new to Ichimoku, single span B is the upper part of the Kumo when it's bearish Kumo. So single span B is flat right now, the angle is flat. So what does that mean? You think about it in yourself. So single span B is flat, single span B is showing a long-term market momentum direction, and that's flat. And that means in the long term, it's flat in range. Simply that's what it means. And so your question was, so I say this is downtrend cases, this is downtrending, but single span B is flat. But is it okay? Is a question. So I mean, is it okay to trade right now, to sell, is a question. So after you ask this question, then try to come up some answer in yourself before you ask me or somebody else in the community. So let's say, okay, Senkospan B showing long term, but K says Kumo's down, Senkospan A is down, Kijunsen down, Chikospan below. So what he says is that this is downtrending, and I expect, he says he expects the market goes bearish in wave like this. So in that sense, this is not really what he looks at. Maybe you can think of this kind of answer, for example. And then you ask this question to me. Or you can ask me, so you say downtrend, case is downtrend, you say downtrend, but would you not look at Senkospan B angle? You can ask this question, and this question becomes more effective for your learning. And also when I answer to that question, that will also become effective in learning to others who are joining on the public live streams or in the group, or you know, when I hear my answer in the comments. So this is one of the examples of effectiveness of asking right question. And so in order to do that, make sure to have answer in yourself before you ask that question to somebody else. And this is not only for my live stream or videos, but also you can apply it to any situations, like when you're in the office, when you want to ask something that you don't know to your boss, then try to come up with your answer first and then ask that question to your boss, so that you can fill the gap in between your answer and your boss's answer, and you can best learn in this process. And you can, of course, apply it on your day-to-day trading also. And like I mentioned before, trading is an isolated process. Basically, after all, we have to trade by ourselves. We have to make decisions by ourselves with our responsibility, with your own responsibility. So this type of critical questions and answer sessions within yourself is so, so effective and powerful. So speaking of this who, what, why, where, when, and how questions, let me break it down further and how you can ask these questions when you actually see charts. So if you want to ask about Euro USD, for example, so sometimes I get the questions like, you know, when I see screen charts, how about Euro USD? Or what do you think about Euro USD? Or could you look at Euro USD? Well, I get these questions, and I'm not saying that these questions are bad, because anyways, I check charts and I explain how I think about these markets, and that is totally fine with me. But I just wonder if it's really learning for you, is today's question. And also my suggestion is to ask right questions. So before asking how about Euro USD, you can ask yourself these six questions, 5W and 1H questions. So one, who, right? So who will be buyers or sellers? So whether buyers winning or sellers are losing, winning, you can think about these, you know, situations in your head. And then you can you may ask what question. So the examples will be, in what indicators do you think it's bearish or range or bullish? Are you using Ichimoku? Are you meaning candlesticks? Are you meaning waves? Are you meaning trend line? Etc. Or Bollinger Bands, maybe stochastics, maybe Fibonacci could be the one. So in what reason or based on what indicators or based on what findings do you think Euro USD is bearish or bullish or range? So you may be able to ask yourself on this question. And also ask yourself where. So where would you think the market goes? Is it bullish? Do you think the market goes up or down, bearish? Where the market goes, you can ask yourself and come up with the answer. And then when. Ask question when yourself. So when to trade or until when you hold could be the question yourself. And also why. So why question is the most effective and most powerful question. You can ask why question to any situations. So like why are you using Ichimoku and why are you saying Ichimoku showing downtrend in this situation? Or why you think it's flat? Why you think this is not a good timing to sell? Or why did you took a sell already today and maybe losing right now or break even right now? So you may ask yourself why you are deciding, you are saying that and why you have decided that before you ask these questions. And also how question, how do you analyze charts and how do you take trades? How would you take trades? If you're thinking to sell today on EURUSD for some reason, then how would you sell? I mean, this is for me, this is bearish. I only look for the sell chance, but for you, if you're also looking for the selling edge today, how would you sell? Do you look at the when you sell? Do you sell when the market breaks that Tenkan-sen, or do you look at the 5-minute chart like I do, or 15-minute chart like I do, and break it down to lower time frames and see candlesticks patterns and look for the selling edge? But in this situation, how would you sell? And how would you trade, or how, until when would you hold, is the question you might ask yourself. So these are just some examples, and of course I think there must be many more questions that you can think of, but you know, like this, you may want to think about these questions and answer yourself before you ask to somebody else, so that it helps you really to learn yourself and also, you know, really study on what I say on the live stream or video sessions. And the reason why I say this is that, once again, I'm more than welcome to, you know, ask me any questions. You know, I'm not against any sort of questions unless it's kind of violating or repeating questions. It's totally okay. But the reason why I say this is that because I ask these questions myself every time I take trades, every time I see charts, every time I analyze charts 3 times per day, I ask these questions myself. Unconsciously, I do. So that's why I decided to introduce this topic today, because that was one of my breakthrough from losing to winning trader. So you can practice in your day-to-day trades also. So when you trade yourself, you know, before taking trades, before executing trades, simply ask yourself why you think this, why you think that, and how would you trade, and do you think buyers are winning, sellers are losing, and what confirmations do you use to trade, and also when would you trade or hold, and also how would you take trades, and why do you think so? You think about these questions before you take trades is very, very effective. So you can apply this on the day-to-day trades, and also, like I mentioned, in my live stream or in others' live stream, maybe if you are following somebody else's you know, live stream or video sessions, before simply asking some question, you can come up with this your own answers and then ask that question to anybody, and then that will be the best learning for yourself. That is for sure. So in conclusion, what I would like to say is realize the power of asking right questions and answer by yourself. And this is the only way to come up with the confidence in yourself and also the best learning for yourself, in my experience. So that was the topic for today. So thank you for watching until the end. So hopefully, I will, you know, I can give you some, you know, good advice, and also I was able to share some good knowledge based on my experience today's video. So if you liked it And if you think you learned something new from today's video, please press the like button before you leave. That would be great. And I will see you on the next one. So once again, thank you for watching until the end, and I will see you again. So until then, please stay healthy, stay safe, and stay gold. Bye bye for now. Mata ne, everyone. Thank you.